What's the connection between the scroll of Megillat Rut to Kabbalat HaTorah? The fact that it's the Yortzeit of David HaMelech? This is the connection? Why reading Megillat Rut? What's the connection between Megillat Rut to Kabbalat HaTorah? And he explained that in the Megillat Rut, we can see over there, we know that Rut, she was very righteous, she was very modest, and the Torah, the Megillah is praising her on her modesty, that she was bending to pick the stalks in a modest way, and more and more. And we know that she was following after Naomi. And Naomi, she was a very righteous woman. And Ruth decided to follow after Naomi in Mesirut Nefesh. And Ruth is saying to Naomi, wherever you're going to go, I'm going to follow you, and I'm going with you, and the place that you're going to live, I'm going to live in that place, and the place that you're going to die, I'm going to die in that, and your nation is my nation, and your God is my God. And she revealed her decision, her will, to follow Naomi. But Naomi put her in a certain test, and that test is very special. She sent her in the middle of the night. She's saying to her, now go, take a shower, put perfume, dress the most beautiful dress that you have, go at night to the barn, to the place that Boaz is going to be in that place, and lie down on the bed. And she's actually telling her to attempt Boaz, to do something that is not allowed according to the rules of Judaism. And all of the Ma'aviyot been blamed on that thing, that they failed Bnei Israel. Now everyone gonna say, she's risking herself very much to do that thing. People gonna say, now that Moaviyah came with Naomi, and she's trying to fail Boaz, the chief rabbi of all of Am Israel, the head of Sanhedrin. And then she's saying to Ruth, to Naomi, she's saying to her, whatever you're gonna tell me, I'm gonna do. And this is the connection. That Am Israel are saying to HaKadosh Baruch Hu in Matan Torah, Na'aseh v'nishma. What it means, Na'aseh v'nishma? You cannot say Na'aseh v'nishma. We'll do what we're going to hear. What it means. So what you're going to do, you don't know what to do. If you haven't heard, you don't know what to do. So you cannot do until you're going to hear. So how can it be that Am Israel are saying, we're going to do what we're going to hear? We're going to do. First of all, going to do. How can you do that? You cannot. So actually, when Am Israel said to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, Na'aseh v'nishma, we'll do what that we're going to hear, and by that they revealed their will to throw all of their wisdoms, to throw away all of their wisdoms, and to count on Hashem Itbarach, and to tell Hashem, whatever you're going to command us, we'll do, even if it's against our wisdom, even if it's against logic. When you listen to the righteous man, he can tell you things to do that are going to sound for you the opposite of all wisdom, the opposite of all logic, of all of what that you learned until now from the Torah Kedosha, that you received from that rabbi himself. He can contradict himself. And you need to throw all of your wisdoms and to count on him. To everything that he's going to tell you, because he's the one. Until you find that one, that you know that he's the one. And from the moment that he found that one, you're counting on him, whatever going to be, going to be.
It's just a temporary world, that in this world, in this period of time, we have a mission. What's the mission? The mission is only not to forget the Creator, to remember that it's all him, never to fall in the trap of all of those coverings, of all of those husks.